Wishful Thinking Projects is a YouTube channel I recently started because I admit I probably spend a lot more time working on my workshop than I do on stuff that actually leaves my workshop. I've come up with a lot of things over the years that could help you with your own ideation or actually help you replicate something I've created. So if you like what you see, please subscribe, please like, and maybe even leave a comment or two and say hi. All right, today's video. It's all about the bits and pieces that need to fit together when assembling a 4-inch based PVC dust collection network. A key theme to this system is friction fitting parts together so that we can change things up over time as you figure out your flow. So in my network, I've lucked out and I've managed to set it all out without ever having to bring out a heat gun to mold anything or get anything 3D printed because I don't have one of those. So I did a bunch of research. I leveraged a few ideas from some people, and I've also figured out a bunch of things on my own. Now I've consolidated it all together into one working system that I'm sharing with you today. And that way you can minimize the amount of frustration it can cause when trying to figure out what works with what. From hoses, to couplers, to elbows, to pipes, to blast gates, I've come up with a component selection that all plays nice together. I'll quickly tell you about my dust collection system so you can have a better idea of what applies to you and what doesn't. And even if you're planning a totally different setup, hopefully you take away an idea or two that helps save you some frustration. So I have a 1.5 horsepower Cyclone dust collector that's sitting in the room next door, and it serves my one car garage size workshop quite well. I have a total of 5 blast gates that I only leave one blast gate open at a time, and I only use one tool at a time. My system is PVC based, and I chose PVC because it's readily available at various box stores around town, it's easy to work with, and it's mostly plug and play. There's no need to glue or tape to seal the joints. A lot of my system is friction fit, so I can change my mind quite easily and reconfigure things. And in some exception cases, I did have to screw the parts together to keep them up in the air and defying gravity. PVC does generate annoying static, so I did ground my system with copper tape and some screws every once in a while to penetrate through the housing. But other than that, I'm going to avoid that whole discussion about PVC causing explosions in a workshop. Okay, we're going to work our way out from the dust collector toward the various tools. So we'll start off with the connections that we're not going to take on and off very much. So the first connection here is from a flexible hose to a rigid pipe. Now what you're looking for is a female end or a flared end. And what I found is that the flexible hose does fit into the female end quite well. However, it's a very tight fit and it's tricky to do, so I'm not going to try and do it live on this video. But you can kind of work it in, and I had to use some soapy water to help it out. But once it's done, and then you can leave that. So I've used the connection like this for my dust collector into the wall where the rigid pipe starts. So this is where this connection comes handy. Let's talk about our choice of blast gates. So I've chosen a 5-inch blast gate here for our 4-inch dust collection network. There's a big key reason to that, is that the blast gate typically will fit inside the piping here, and so if you choose a 4-inch blast gate, it actually restricts your airflow. It would be the smallest diameter part of my entire dust collection network. So using a 5-inch blast gate, it does not restrict any of the airflow because the opening's nice and wide, and we're going to fit our parts inside this flange instead of outside of it. Now there is a design flaw with these in the sense that this sliding piece here is a lot thinner than the channel that it rides in, and so a lot of air will flow into the gaps here on both sides and it rattles, etc. But it's a really easy fix, and I'll show you how I fixed it. Okay, let's open up this blast gate and check out the advanced techniques that I've used to seal this guy up. All right, on this side of the blast gate, I've got one layer of Gorilla Tape here, one layer of Gorilla Tape there. And on the other side of the blast gate, I went all out. And I've got 4 layers of Gorilla Tape here and 4 layers of Gorilla Tape there. So this effectively seals the system up so that when this blast gate is closed, it's not letting extra air into the system. Okay, connecting the blast gate to the network. So because we've chosen a 5-inch blast gate that's a little bit larger in diameter, we need to use the larger female end of the fitting or the female end of a 10-foot long PVC pipe. But that's rare to come by, so we'll just focus on the fitting. Now check this out. It just fits. Just like that. We can see that the fitting comes up about 1/4 inch to the end of the blast gate or the blast gate surface. Sometimes I do use a layer of Gorilla Tape to seal that up a little bit better and get a snugger fit, but right off the bat, it's pretty good. So a quick tip on how I attach the blast gate to the wall or hang a pipe off the ceiling, I use a small block of wood that has a channel in it for a tie strap to fit into, and I just simply screw that into the wall or into the ceiling. So for a blast gate, it's screwed into the wall and the flange of the blast gate just sits on the block of wood while the tie strap keeps it nice and tight against there. And in the ceiling case, it's basically hanging off the ceiling, suspending the pipe. Now we need to start connecting our hoses to our blast gates and eventually to our tools. So my favorite way of doing this is to use a hose clamp and then a screw-on coupler or screw-on quick connect. It's a reverse thread, so we'll just thread that on there. And then you tighten the hose clamp, and then you're done. So a conformable hose is basically you can stretch it out, and you can shape it, and it holds its shape. You actually don't even need a hose clamp for this, but I use a quick connect coupler, a screw-on tight. Two key takeaways for you in this clip. One is friction fit as much as you can so you can reconfigure things over time. And second is when you are friction fitting on a vertical drop like this, use an elbow, and I'll tell you why in a second. So in this example, I've got conformable hose that's friction fit into this small segment of straight pipe. The small segment of straight pipe is friction fit into the elbow, and the elbow itself is friction fit into the blast gate with a little bit of help of Gorilla Tape here to snug things up. So remember that second takeaway is to always use an elbow on a vertical drop like this. And the reason is, once you've got the hose connected, the weight of that hose on this elbow makes it torque about the joint here. And that additional torque increases the amount of friction here so it never falls out. I've probably had it set up like this for well over a year and it's never come out accidentally. Now, if I were to just insert a pipe or a hose straight up into this blast gate, I would have to fasten or anchor it somehow to prevent it from sliding straight out. Just to note, everything above this is a straight drop, so I have had to screw things together to get everything above this blast gate to stay together. Here's another example of how I used an elbow to fit this together here. This quick connect coupler simply slides into this 22.5 degree elbow here, and that elbow is actually just friction fit into the blast gate here as well. All right, let's talk about connecting to our tools. So we'll start with a special case here with my Milwaukee 6955 miter saw. It's got a really big throat here to collect dust. And in the back, I've actually hacked it so that I can fit a 4-inch dust hose to fit right there. In the simplest case, an output port of a tool is really easy to connect to a quick connect here. You can just directly connect it. And of course, if you want to save the cost of not buying a quick connect, you can just directly connect the hose to the tool. And it all depends on your use case if you move things around or not. So what I've found is that the output ports of most tools fits the inside of a male end of a PVC fitting. So you have to get the special kind that has a spigot end or a male end because that's not as standard as the two female end versions of these fittings. I am relying on the inside diameter of the fitting to match the outside diameter of the tool, but depending on the brand, it's not always a perfect fit, so you gotta luck out a bit. But from what's available in Home Depot here in Canada, it fits right on, just like that. And then so then I can get my quick connect coupler that fits right into there. And if you angle this perfectly, it clears the outfeed of the 735X planer. So there you go. There's an overview of my dust collection network and all the parts that fit together. So hopefully this has helped you out. And if so, please like, please subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Oh, by the way, if you have extras left over, you can make some pretty cool jewelry out of this.